have heard of some of these conditions: Parkinson's disease, Tourette syndrome, maybe Huntington's disease. These all land on the list of conditions known as movement disorders. They can cause tremors, maybe involuntary movement, and trouble getting around. Well, here to help us better understand these is Amy Marriott. She is a physical therapist at Cone Health, Cone Neuro Rehabilitation Center. They specialize in Parkinson's disease, and I want to stay there because I have a personal interest in this. My mother died last month, and she had dealt with Parkinson's for more than 20 years, which is an unusually long time.
Absolutely.
We think of the tremors. She had tremors at the beginning, but really her issue was the incredible rigidity her body developed. What do you do about that? Is that common, and what do you do about that?
Yes, rigidity can be one of the effects of Parkinson's disease, and that's where there's an imbalance of the muscle tone, where there's just stiffness, and it's more difficult to move. Stretching and activation of some of those weaker muscles to get those stronger, different types of exercise such as aerobic activity, and then stretching and high intensity exercise.
And I'm sure they help. I don't want to get people to get maybe too encouraged about how much you can. To what degree can you help is what I'm getting at here, because I think, you know, people may think, well, I'll be normal if I do these, and it's never really going to be normal, is it?
One of the things that we focus on as therapists, physical therapists, occupational therapists, and speech therapists at our neuro rehab center, is helping each individual patient to find what their normal can be, what they can achieve to improve their functional mobility, to be as independent and as safe as possible at whatever stage of the disease process it is.
Now, what type of time frame is involved in this? So if I'm going to take therapy, and I know, as you say, it's going to be individualized for patients, but generally, are we talking something every day, an hour a day maybe? Does it need to be more than that?
So as therapists, what we recommend for therapy sessions may be several times a week, where there's guided individualized treatments. And we always promote the education factor with the patient and the family that they're carrying out the exercises on a daily basis. We recognize that the daily exercise is very important.
Yeah, every day. And you find that the patient's state of mind is essential?
We really hope that they buy into therapy, for sure, and that's why we incorporate the patient's family for education, for motivation, and then we also try to encourage different groups, exercise groups, or things that can also improve the motivation factor where the patient can be actively engaged.
But you've seen pretty good results, right, if they follow the protocol?
We're always very hopeful, and we know through research and through our experience that intensity and the high frequency and duration of exercise, the more that they can do at the right types and the right frequency of exercise, is very important, and we see lots of positive changes.
Well, you guys do great work there at Cone, and in fact, if you'd like to find out more about movement disorders like Parkinson's disease, you can check out conehealth.com/Parkinson's. You can also find classes and groups sponsored by Cone Health. There, in fact, there's a Parkinson's education seminar coming up this month. It is free, will include breakfast and a resource fair. That's July 13th at the Union Square campus in Greensboro. That's the one on the south end of downtown. You can register at conehealth.com/classes or call the number you see there, 832-3060.
House Call on Fox 8 is sponsored by Cone Health.